Hi.
Hi. Welcome to Why Are We Like This, a Heartstopper podcast. I'm Ashley, she, her.
And I'm Alyssa, she, they.
And we're here today to talk about the first 2 minutes of Heartstopper Season 2 and the teaser trailer and the episode titles. We have a lot of fun stuff to talk
There's
about.
There's been today. A lot. Yeah, I know folks have been wanting us to talk about the first 2 minutes and the episode titles for a while now, but, you know, life. Ashley decided to be, in the middle of nowhere in the woods when this announcement was made. And I'm in the middle of moving 2 states away. So, you know.
Things are a bit
life.
Crazy.
But we are, but we're here now. And we are so excited to talk about all of this. I have a lot of thoughts about the episodes. And if you were in the Discord, like right after the episode titles were announced, you know that I have a lot of thoughts about certain speculative things. We'll get to that, though.
I'm excited to hear all your thoughts and feelings because I did not go back and catch up on Discord whenever I got back from my trip. So this is all going to be new information for me. So I'm excited to hear what you have to say.
So we're going to start just by rewatching the first 2 minutes and then we'll talk about it.
Yes. 3, 2, 1, play.
I love that he has like half of the.
I know. So Nick has the other half up in his room, I'm sure.
Yes, it's so cute.
I also, everyone is freaking out about how he has his alarm set to 7:14 instead of like 7:10 or 7:15. I'm like, that's me though. Sometimes I just like, I want to get up close-ish to 7 and I'll just like scroll it and see what happens.
Yeah.
You can't even get dressed properly. I love it. Still got a full bowl of cereal, though.
Yep.
Tori. I love the parallel.
I know a lot of people, I know a lot of people are disappointed that it's not Kit, that it's not Nick, like, parallel last season, but I love it.
That's honestly, that was my guess, was that we would get Nick walking in, but I love the way they've done it. The way my heart dropped.
This is perfect.
When he was not there, though.
Yes, but then it's so cute.
Yes, it's so perfect.
Oh my God.
They grab each other's hands in class.
It's so cute.
Oh, the back end of this season is going to be hard.
Yeah. This whole season's going to be hard.
Yes, but I think the back end is going to be particularly hard.
I think it just depends on a few different things.
And also, like, how they work out. Will all the hard things for all the characters be happening at the same time? Or are they going to be like, Darcy's having a hard time, but Nick and Charlie are fine. And then by the time Darcy's fine, Nick and Charlie are having a hard time. Like, how are they going to balance all of that?
Yeah, it's going to be an angsty season for sure.
Yeah.
But, like, we knew that.
Yep. Yeah.
Jeez. It's like everyone's like, Paris trip. And like, yes, but like also it's just like
so much more.
So many things are happening.
I feel like season 2 is going to, like, the perfect representation is that like Kristen Bell gif where she's like, so like it starts out so like hee 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 and then you're like when you remember all the rest of it.
Oh my God. Yes. And, you know, it's like, it's interesting trying to piece together because we do know some new stuff is coming. Like, there's three new characters that we've never met before because they're not in the show. We also have our characters who, you know, are new to this series from last season. Lots of, like, places for things to be different from the comics, which is kind of where I had to, like, stop taking notes because I was like, ah, there's too many variables.
You cannot predict everything.
No, I do, however, think I have the first episode pretty solidly mapped out.
Let's hear it.
So, out. I think that it's pretty solidly going to follow the comics, where we have Charlie telling his parents about Nick being his boyfriend and that lovely conversation, which is, I think, where we're going to start to get some Jane Spring nonsense. Because we don't have a lot of Jane Spring nonsense yet. And then, because that also covers exams and, you know, them studying and doing all of that, which also gives a nice chance for them to do the lads.
Exactly what I was thinking. It's like we could get the wrestling scene.
Rectifying. Yep. It also gives them a chance to rectify their other sin of not giving us enough Cy, Christian, and Otis, because this would cover the really good mates scene.
Yeah.
Where Cy, Christian, and Otis apologize and they're like, we realize that Harry's dick. And Cy, is it?
What a good way to start off the season.
Yes, I think the really good mate scene, which then could also, like, include some of Nick's insecurities about, like, being out and, like, struggling to come out to some people still. And then that also means that we would get Coach Singh catching Nick and Charlie in the equipment shed, which I know a bunch of people are like, well, why would that happen if Charlie's quit rugby? But Charlie could just be hanging out with Nick. Like, or he could rejoin the team. Who knows? There's a lots of different possibilities. And then we end with David. Like, Nick gets home and there's David. And then it ends there because the second episode is called Family. And so, yeah, my prediction with Family is lots of David's bullshit.
Yeah, and probably more Jane, right? Like, they'll gear up Jane in episode one. And then in episode two is when we're going to get probably a lot of David and Jane stuff.
Yeah, and I feel like because, like, the Paris trip meeting would also ostensibly be around there. So we could have some Jane bullshit with that, too. And then I was also thinking, because it's called Family, maybe they'll start to plant the seeds of Nick's dad even earlier. And then take it from there.
Yeah. I'm sure he'll at least be mentioned and if then David shows up.
Yeah, definitely. And then Promise is where my predictions fall apart. well, no, because I know that Heat and Truth Dare are going to be Paris. Like, just because.
Yeah. It's obvious.
It's obvious from the titles. But then from there, it's questionable what exactly is going on everywhere else. So Promise, Challenge, Sorry, and Perfect, I have a much less good plan.
I have to imagine that Promise is a reference to Nick asking him if he can tell him if he feels like that in the future. And he's like, do you promise? That's the only thing that I can think of.
Because here's the thing, right? The big question a lot of folks have is, when is prom going to happen? Because, you know, the exams are at the end of the school year, and then that kind of feeds into the Paris trip. So it's like, where is prom going to be? And a bunch of people are saying, well, prom is. And I was like, no, that's stupid.
Yeah.
And the reason I think it's stupid is because it doesn't make narrative sense unless we want to have angsty prom, and Alice would not do that to us.
At first, I was like, promise. But then when you pointed out, like, where it was in the timeline, I was like, you're right.
Because, like, Nick has to have his big, like, public coming out moment in Truth Dare. Yeah. It has to be. There's nowhere else that it could be. I refuse to believe that they would cut that scene.
Yeah.
They wouldn't devote an entire episode to the truth or dare. Like, they titled the episode that. It's gonna be a big moment. So, narratively, it just makes more sense. Because if it's in episode 3, it's gonna be all of this angst and Nick and Charlie having to hide. But you want prom to be a celebratory thing. You want it to be happy and exciting. And so I would assume that it's gonna end the season. And also, not for nothing, the trailer gives me further confidence that prom is gonna be episode 8. Which I will discuss once we get there.
Yeah. Also, before we move on from the first 2 minutes, love the song. Love the song choice.
Yeah, it's Shatter by Maggie Rogers.
Yeah.
I do. I like the song choice. I like the energy of it. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
I will say I was initially a little disappointed that it wasn't Baby Queen again, but, you know. Yeah.
I think she'll be included
we
in
still
that.
Got it.
You know, like.
Oh, certainly.
For sure. All right, so now we're going to watch the teaser trailer and talk about that.
And probably cry.
I'm going to try my best not to cry. I cried a lot.
It's been a crying kind of.
It really has. All right. 3, 2, 1, play.
This sound effect gets me. Yellow Converse.
It's so good. Everything's gonna be perfect. I immediately.
That is a lot in only 35 seconds.
It is. I immediately put it on my computer into my program and did it like frame by frame so that I could look at everything closely.
I thought about doing that, but I'm like, I'll let Ashley do that.
Yeah, I also made
slow-mo. I'll be unhinged about the episode.
I made slow-mo versions of everything too, so.
And then you texted me all your feelings about Tara and Darcy.
Yeah, I don't like that face we get in the museum. I don't like that little clip. It makes me nervous. It could be anything.
Things that could be going on there.
It could be anything. Also, right. Isaac crying. So. That hurts me.
Is he crying?
Yes. Both cheeks have tears. I have to think it's in relation to Truth or Dare and being overwhelmed because of his Arrow Ace feelings.
Yeah.
But it hurts me.
Yeah, because it looks like the Truth or Dare because we have the same decor as when they have Darcy has the vodka and they're all cheering about that.
Yeah, it's the same room.
So
it's definitely during the party.
I was trying to look. Is that also the same room? No, it's different. Okay. There's, the clip at the end that you were thinking is prom, but it's different lighting. Like, it's the same, color lighting.
It is.
But it's, a different drop.
And a huge crowd, too, behind them. And I have to imagine, after watching it in slow motion, that something's going on with L in that scene because Tao is standing behind her looking at her so lovingly and proud, and then all the other three of them turn and look at her while they're clapping and she's just standing there smiling. Yeah. So something's happening with L there.
What if L wins prom queen or whatever? Right? If that's what that is, I would cry.
Because they're not, in formal wear, but they are dressed nice. All of them. So, it could be.
I don't know.
The last time we were talking about like promposals and stuff, someone was like, oh, I hate to like burst your bubble, but proms are very different in the UK than they are in the US. And I was like, oh. So I was like, well, maybe it's not like a formal affair. Maybe it's more of like a homecoming type deal.
I feel like, I mean, really the only girl that we get a good shot of is Elle, and Elle always is like stunning. But
Right.
I feel like at the very least the guys seem like, obviously we can't see what kind of pants they're wearing, so they might be
Right.
wearing like khakis or dress pants, and that might change the vibe a bit. But like Charlie's wearing like
A plannel.
a flannel button down, and Isaac is wearing
They all have on
like a
button
bowling
downs,
shirt
yeah.
almost. It's a slightly weird vibe, but that being said, I'm also Eddie wears button downs like open almost every day, so I feel like that for me is just like a casual look, but maybe
Well,
it
but also
depends.
you have to think about like teens. If they're getting dressed up to go to like a dance, a t-shirt with a nice button down is kind of like fancy for a teen, you know?
Trying to remember what guys wore to like dances, like homecoming type dances when I was in school.
It was definitely like nice pants and button ups for me, which is maybe why that's why I like leaned that way immediately, because that
Maybe.
looks like how I grew up. Also,
Feel like a lot of guys wore ties too. Maybe that's just a
well,
misremembering though.
also I grew up like in a very small like farm town, so like button ups are nice for little boys, you know what I mean? Like they're not in their Wranglers and boots, so they feel fancy. I also want to point out that in the Tao and Elle stuff, we get that shot of Elle looking at Tao like really sadly close up, and he has his hair flips, which means we're gonna get to see him cut his hair.
Yeah, and I have to imagine that this is gonna be kind of like, I don't know, either him feeling guilty about like Charlie stuff or I don't know, some kind of aftermath of.
Yeah. Or he could be complaining about relationship stuff. Like, all my friends have relationships, blah, blah, blah. And she's like, I'm right here.
Darcy. In this one clip in the Louvre, Tara looks like they might be like having an argument or something, and I
Yeah,
don't like that.
it looks to me as though they were having a conversation and Darcy was like, I don't want to talk about this right now, and walked off a little bit faster, leaving Tara to be like, she's not okay and I feel bad about it. I'm excited to see like what we'll get about Darcy's family and stuff. I mean, excited. I'm interested to see where. I'm not excited for it. Let me
Yes,
redact
that's a fair.
that.
But like on a happy note, we also have this like little bit of Tao and Elle like spinning around
Yeah,
in like
so
an art
cute.
museum.
And we get the
So,
vodka reveal at the party.
yes, which is great. So we're kind of looking at a lot of the more angsty stuff because we are scared, but there is still happiness to be found in
Yeah.
this. I have a lot of emotions.
It's going to be a good season. Also, can we talk about how, like, season one was already like really good quality, but season two already looks like it's on another level. Which is exciting. Oh, and can we talk about how we did not get Imogen or Tori in this teaser at all?
And we also don't really get to see any of our new characters.
We get like half a second of Sahar.
And that's it. But we don't see any of the other new characters. And we don't even really get a look at Sahar, which makes sense. They want to draw you in. It's a
Right.
teaser.
Yeah.
They want to draw you in with the characters
Right.
that you already know.
I'm
But
sure
they
we'll
could have done
get.
a little, like.
For the full trailer, I'm sure we'll have.
Yes. Which will hopefully be soon.
I mean, we're, this is July the 2nd, so we're 1 month out. In the next couple of weeks, we'll be getting the full trailer.
God. Of course, that'll be right in the middle of my, like, actual moving, like, packing up. I mean, I'm packing up now, but, like, putting shit in a truck and driving 3 hours. Yeah. But, you know, we'll figure it out.
Yeah. Okay, so we also got the poster.
Mm-hmm.
Which is super cute. We got, like, the still poster and the animated poster. Did you see the animated one?
I haven't seen the animated one. Is it on their Instagram?
At most posted it.
Oh, that's so cute. Daw.
Yeah, very, very cute. Yes. I love how everyone just, like, filters in and the leaves are going all around them.
I love... The thing I love the most about this, though, is you have Nick and Charlie. You have, like, Tao and Elle coupled up. You have Tara and Darcy coupled up. And then you have Isaac with his one
in his book.
A book.
I know. It's so cute.
And I totally just tried to zoom in to figure out what book it is, but it is not high enough resolution image.
No.
For me to figure it out. I'm sure someone somewhere knows.
I also love the tagline, show the world what love is made of.
Yeah, it's so cute. It's really cute. And it definitely, it made me, like, really emotional the first time that I watched the... Well, the second time that I watched it, because the first time I watched it was on Alice's live stream.
Right.
And just because of the angle, I couldn't quite read what it said. But once I watched it, the YouTube video, I was unwell.
Yeah. I also just wanted to talk about this. I'm springing this on you because I'm just, like, looking through my screenshots at this point. But everybody's outfits at Pride yesterday, the cast looks so good. They all look so good.
Yes.
My favorite outfit was Kizzy's. And my favorite video of the cast is, like, by far when they went by the protesters. And the float, like, stopped to let them obviously, like, flip off the protesters and stuff. Fucking icon. Toby Donovan. Like, twerks. Like, twerked for them.
Oh,
and
God.
While he was doing it, Kit was slapping his ass. Like, yeah, yeah. I was like, this is my favorite.
I haven't seen this.
Oh, I can send that to you immediately. It's so good.
All right. I do, though, now. I am obsessed with Corey's outfit.
Yes.
With the pants and the sunglasses.
Yeah, excellent. And the iconic. Top is like chain. I love it. It's like chain mesh, too, when you get up close to it.
Oh, that's amazing.
Very cute. Will's sweater.
Why am I not like, on Tokyo's
tank gym? Top sweater.
Mm-hmm.
Adorable.
Sebastian's, like, shoulder thingies.
Yes. And Kit's got on the shirt that he wore previously. I think it was he wore the black one, but it's got, like, the shirtless man on the back.
Mm-hmm.
His stylist put up a picture of him in a t-shirt with a buff unicorn smoking a cigarette with rainbow tattoos and, like, a bazooka that was shooting rainbow hearts. And I was like, okay, but where's that shirt? Because I love that.
Yes. Just lots of excellence.
Yes,
all around.
It was great content yesterday. It was lovely. But yeah, I think that's all I have for these, except for being extremely excited and wanting it to skip this month and just be August already.
Yes. I mean,
a lot because it's my birthday month.
It is your birthday month. I always forget that you're a July Leo.
Yeah.
The inferior kind of Leo.
I mean, agree to disagree, but whatever.
All right. Well, that's everything we have for now. And until next time, bye.
Bye.